April 7th, 1506, 500 years ago, St. Francis Xavier was born. Hundreds of years later, his powerful presence is heard. Every day you walk through the doors of Xavier High School and experience his holy presence, physically through the building and spiritually through the miracles he performed through God's intervention. But do you know who he was? What his miracles were? What he did to become a man like Christ? To do that, we go back 500 years. St. Francis Xavier was born in a castle in Spain. He was the third son of the president of the council to the King of Narva. As was often the case with younger sons of nobility of the time, he was destined for a religious career. He received a fundamental education in Spain, and in 1525, he journeyed to the University of Paris, the theological center of Europe, to begin his study. St. Francis and St. Ignatius Loyola were roommates in college. Francis was in his 20s, Ignatius was near 40.
So one day, I was about 14 years old, and I was praying in my family's chapel when I heard a call from God to become a priest. My father said that this is the best university for miles. After he died, I decided to come here. So what's your story?
Well, I was a cleric in the Spanish army. I was discharged. I decided to come here for atonement.
You were fighting in a war for your country, for God. You have nothing to atone for.
If you had known things I've done, you'd want to repent too.
You're right. I'm sorry.
It's all right, Francis. When you're near 40, you'll understand. Life's a fleeting thing.
Hey, I meant to ask you, what is that?
This old thing? It's nothing important.
Oh, well, can I see it?
Well, I guess you can see it.
Who are the Jesuits?
Loyola told Francis that when he came back from the war, he was inspired to start a new Catholic religious society called the Jesuits. Ignatius noticed that God was in many things, oftentimes in the smallest places one would never expect. He wanted to bring the idea of magis, meaning war, to life. Magis is an important part of the Jesuits' lifestyle. It meant to seek more knowledge, to seek a more religious lifestyle, and to incorporate it in everyday life.
So who else do you want me to recruit for you?
No, I don't even think that's possible.
Well, Ignatius, I think this is a good idea. Think of the good it can do for the world.
You think so?
Yes, you've been a good friend to me, Ignatius, and I would like to see this through. If you are looking for atonement, this is it.
The zealous compassion that St. Francis showed to St. Ignatius Loyola helped start the Jesuit mission all around the world. The Jesuits reached England to Japan. St. Francis was filled with the Holy Spirit and was given the gift of tongues, which allowed him to speak many languages. St. Francis Xavier died at the age of 46 off the coast of China. This seemed to be the end of St. Francis Xavier's legacy until 1839. The man who reminded the world of the good deeds of St. Francis Xavier was Theodore James Ryken. He was orphaned at a young age. Raised by his uncle, Ryken was a shoemaker by trade. As he got older, he felt a strong presence from God to become a man of the cloth. He became a catechist and started his own orphanage to help children stricken with cholera. He traveled twice to America to help missionaries of the Native Americans. On his second trip in 1837, Ryken noticed something shocking in American cities.
So, as you can see here, brother, things here are quite healthy and nurturing.
No, stop!
Stop! What was that all about?
Yeah, you know, boys will be boys, brother.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. All right.
And as you can see, here's our math room. All right. Pretty state of the art.
5, 2 plus 7?
No, it's
3.
2 plus 2
is
2
6.
2 plus 2
is
Mr.
6.
Mr. Opalatz, is this the right answer?
Let me see this.
Oh, yeah. 2 plus 2? 22? I'd say you're golden.
Yes!
Wait. 2 plus 2 is 4.
Oh, yeah! 4!
Lord in heaven, please help these children.
What's that?
What's what?
Lord?
What's Lord? Are you kidding me?
Mr. Thompson.
Yes, Brother Ryken.
A word, if you will. They don't know who God is. They can't answer a simple math problem. The teacher just fell asleep. What's wrong with this school?
Yeah, you know, we tried that whole professional teaching thing and it wasn't working out. The teachers were given homework. I mean, who wants to do work outside of class?
Yeah, it's called homework. It's supposed to be a reinforcer of what they're learning in school.
Yeah, we don't do that here, brother. Listen, when I was 17, I didn't want to do homework. I mean, I want to go out and play and have fun. Hey, these kids, man, they're going to be either in jail or some working at some factory down the street. Let them enjoy their lives.
But you don't get it. With a good Catholic education.
Yeah, you see, Theo. You mind if I call you that? Okay, Theo.
But the teacher was incorrigible. He said, let them enjoy the last few years of adolescence. We don't want them to aim high and miss the mark. So we lowered the bar in our school. When he heard this, Theodore James Ryken saw that the immigrant city children were in more dire need of a religious education than the Native Americans. So, in 1839, Brother Ryken started the Congregation of St. Francis Xavier, or the Xaverian Brothers Order. His mission was based in the roots of the Jesuits. In 1848, the first Xaverian school opened in Britain to help the children's skills in English. In 1854, the first brothers, Paul, Hubert, Stanislaus, Stephen, and Bernardine, arrived in Louisville, Kentucky.
I'm so hungry.
Will you stop complaining? Jesus walked through the desert for 40 days and 40 nights without any food or water.
Yes, but he was God.
You're all a bunch of whining Nancys. What would Jesus say to you if he was here?
Well, I don't know, but you might get to ask him yourself if you don't share some of that water.
I'm sharing the water. I'm thirsty. I'm dying over here. I wanted the water. What's all that hooting and hollering about?
Sir, we've been traveling for miles with nothing to eat.
Not too many people call me sir, but wait right here. I got something in the house for you. Be back in a jiff.
Well, I got a watermelon in the back. It's there if you guys want it.
Food? Thank you so much.
That was the first meal the brothers had in the United States. In the following centuries, the brothers founded over 13 other Xaverian Brothers-sponsored schools in America. The Xaverian values of trust, compassion, simplicity, humility, and zeal are incorporated into our everyday lives. So we gather here today for the feast of St. Francis Xavier, a man truly like Christ. St. Francis Xavier is considered the greatest missionary and preacher of the gospel since the time of the apostles. He was filled with incomparable apostolic zeal and love of God. He is a man we should all strive to be like today.
Good it can do for the world. Go.
Think of the good it can do for the world.
You think so?
Very good.